Hi y'all, Terhi Koskinen here again. Today I'm making a layout for Pebbles and I'm super excited about it because I'm going to use some paints on background and as I want to do it really quickly, I have three different colored paints which are from crepe paper and I haven't used these before, but I can see that those colors are so beautiful. My background is Biggie Pudding mixed media paper, which is really thick and goes well with any mixed media techniques. First, I had this idea about little squares with different colors. And I'm using old bank card or credit card or any card to make those squares. It's also easy because the size is always the same, so it's super easy. So I'm making just random squares. This makes this background quite busy, but I don't mind it. At this phase, I thought about making one picture layout, but these colors are going so well together with these three different photos I have of my dog and our pony, and I wanted to scrapbook these pictures with these colors. And right now I'm making a little frames for each of the photos, and I'm using 3D foam between the photo and the pattern paper, and this is how it will be, at least something like this. But at this pace I can see that this layout is going to be really busy because the background is so much going on over there. So I'm thinking if I could calm it down with some flowers and different patterned papers, but in the end, well, we'll see about that. But first I'm going to do a little paper clusters for each photograph to make them pop up from the background. I just made some paper slices and little pieces of pattern paper, and I'm going to use tape to attach them together, and that's it, like this. And if there is any of those pattern papers too large, you can always cut them off. But as you can see, it really felt like it was way too much going on. So I turn up the paper. It's so thick that you can actually turn the paper around even though you have paint on the other side. And now I'm going to add the same paint, but in a different way. I'm going to add it all with this vertical way, same bank card or credit card, whatever. Actually, that one is gym card, old key, but who cares? It's perfect tool for this. First, I just spread that paint as with the squares first, but now I want to have it in a bit different way. I'm using the card, as you can see, another way, and it needs a bit more of the paint, but it really makes a nice texture for the background, but it still keeps the background really calm because all those lines and all those paint stripes are going to the same direction. It's a little different, but it makes huge difference to what I first did with the squares. But now I can use happily those three pictures, and I know it's going to be good. And what I'm first going to do is that I'm adding white thread to the background, to the places that I'm going to add the photographs. It will make, again, a bit more texture. And now that I have some white there, I also want to have some white splashes. A bit calming down again. Those white splashes are always welcome, especially with the white background. It makes it really cool. So I'm just splashing around and trying not to be too heavy with my hand. Just some splashes and that's it. And I'm going to use these same clusters that I made first. And again, I'm using these 3D foam squares to make everything pop up. I have actually two different sizes, two different thicknesses, or thickness. Anyway, two different sizes of those foams, and it's really cool because I can make them even really thick or just a bit more away from the background. I know my foams are really good adhesives, but if you're not totally sure that if they are going to keep your papers, just add a little strip of glue to make it good. But like I said, with the squares first, that I'm going to add some fuzzy cut flowers. I did so too with this. Most of those flowers are from the latest Jen Hatfield collection, but I'm also using Loves Me collection from last winter, because there are so many beautiful little blooms and all those pink flowers are going so well together. So the rest of the creative process is just adding the right kind of ephemera all the way and some flowers, and that's it. So actually, this was really easy layout, even though it might look like there's so much work to do, but it isn't. It's just paint and then some papers on top, maybe some thread and white splashes, but that's it. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and thank you for watching it. We will see you again soon. Bye!